Good morning, everyone. I'm still awake. Wakey, wakey, everyone. We really need to be breaking this up. It's all gone a little too far. Since 2020 started, there's been so many shifts, so many changes. And this bizarre reality that we were thrown into, there's no words to describe the behavior. The mass, social distancing, physical distancing. You may as well go around with a Kleenex under your face. Like, really. These people that are wearing the masks, these people that are abiding by all of these changes, and they don't seem to have any qualms about it. We have to be from two different realities. 2015, in a couple of days, maybe 5 years since I was woke up and realized that everyone's behavior had changed. Complete completely changed. Adjusting, trying to wake people up, trying to understand and comprehend what's happened, watching everyone bounce and move around in this community. Everyone has a passion and know that this isn't the reality that we came from. And no one seems to know a way out, to break free, to speak the truth, to be the truth, to be that change . It's just very stressful and tiring. Day after day, it's like, what the fuck's next? I spend a little while popped into Facebook and made a post or two. they don't seem to want to hear anyone else's version of the events that transpired. They're wearing a mask, they're social distancing, they're going along with whatever that YouTube tells them. You know, those government leaders, doctors and scientists and specialists, experts, and they can't see the agenda. They can't see the New World Order. I mean, for 30 years, I've been waiting for this moment. You were sent here on a mission in 2015, made aware that this is not what it was, what it seemed. I mean, for God's sake, I woke up one morning and my husband had changed. I mean, everything, my whole world fell apart, smithereens. And riding this roller coaster has worn me down, tired. Like for five, almost 6 months, I'm tongue-tied into how to process any of this verbally, emotionally. I'm spent resurfacing files and chapters that have been closed. Some still hang on to everything. You just have to let it go. Trust, the big factor. The factors here are trust and fear. How can we trust any government? Can't even trust that our family are the same. So why would we be delusional when they are the ones that are delusional? They're the ones that can't accept our reality, and we are supposed to accept theirs. I mean, I won't say argue, but because it's the same argument, for example, with my sister. Oh my goodness. I mean, you couldn't get any further apart. Because of their egos, because of their set in their ways, like, don't think outside the box, just follow what the sheep are doing. That's when I turn around and walk against the herd. So there's these people I've known a lifetime, but haven't seen them in a lifetime. but they are older versions of themselves that okay, I lost my train there, but okay, it lets me get back on track. So on Facebook, she's a retired nurse, so she's giving the amount of cases, I guess, in Ontario, and the amount of people that died, and the amount of people that are waiting to die. So I asked her why she was in so much fear, and what does these numbers really mean? And about wearing the mask and the social distancing. And so whatever I said triggered a whole bunch of these people that I know since I was a child. And telling me to hashtag F off. What's it? I want to just come out and say it. The conspiracy theory, there's blah, blah, blah. And so they were all interacting there, all ganging up on me. And so this went on for like 20 hours. And so the one that made the post said, well, I guess this conversation's done. I guess you didn't win. Or you stand alone on this one. I said, I'm proud to stand alone. I find it freeing.